My family's been coming down here since the 50s, and we've never seen anything quite like it.
This video only tells half the story of the damage on Captiva Island.
Well, it is a lot like going through a war zone.
Some landmarks are gone, and some homes are either washed away or buried in the sand. Chris Howard and his family were in the process of building a place to call home on Captiva. That was until Hurricane Ian wrecked those plans. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Christy Soto.
And I'm Trent Bennett. We were there as Howard and his family walked the island for the first time since the storm.
Only NBC2's Alexia Tropoulos was there to see what they came home to.
The sky is blue, the sun is shining, you know, so it's just a dichotomy between the devastation you see and then watching. We watched the sunset last night on the beach, and, it's a little piece of hope, I think.
It is moments like this which gives Chris Howard and his family hope that things will return to normal.
You guys weren't obviously here for the storm, but coming back and seeing the wreckage left behind, what was the immediate thought, especially knowing you were going to have to rip everything out?
Well, I mean, it was a feeling of overall sadness, right? I mean, this is a house that we've been coming to for, you know, 75 years. I honeymooned in this house back in 1983. My aunts had the house for over 20 years now, and there's a lot of family memories here, and so to have to tear it all down, it's really hard.
Howard has a house under construction, but this mound of debris is from his aunt's house just a block over.
Once everything got wet, everything in the kitchen is now gone, everything in the bathrooms had to be taken out.
There was a high storm surge in this area, which he says was different from Hurricane Charley.
Here's a water line right here. That's how much water got into the house.
That water line hitting 2 feet inside the house.
Once the water receded, it was just this green, mucky silt that was all over the floor.
He says removing these items felt like removing memories his family shared.
Anybody that's been on the island, we talk about it's the price of paradise.
There are signs of hope surrounding the island.
Houses like on the beach down here in the Mucky Duck restaurant, everyone's really happy that it survived, didn't get any water inside, and it was right on the beach.
And many now have their power back on, all signs toward rebuilding. On Captiva Island, Alexia Tropoulos, NBC2.